In this video, let's talk about the vector projection of the vector u onto the vector v. I will first give you guys an introduction and then I'll show you guys an example. Here we go. We have two cases. It depends on the angle between u and v. The first case is when the angle is acute. So I'll draw a picture for you guys. Let's say here is u and let's say this is v and the angle is acute. Now, the vector projection of u onto v, keep in mind the word matters, of u, so you want to go to the end of u, and then you want to just drop a perpendicular, maybe like a dashed line to help you. This right here has to be 90 degrees, u onto v. And then if you go from here to here, this is the projection. Any projection is also going to be a vector. The notation for this is PROJ for projection, and we want to have u onto v, so we put a little subscript right here, u onto v. Now, that's when the angle theta is acute. Well, if the angle theta is 90 degrees, the projection is just zero because u is already perpendicular to v. So the other case is when the angle is obtuse. So let's say here is v, and let's say now this is u. In this case, the angle being obtuse, we will first have to extend v right here, and then do the same thing. Go to the end of u, and then just drop a perpendicular like this. Make sure this right here is 90 degrees. In this case though, the projection is going from here to here. Projection of u onto v. Yeah, so it's the opposite direction. Now, let's see how to formulate this right here. They are factors, so we need the magnitude and also the direction. First, the direction, it's in the v direction here, right? So let's just take a look at the unit factor right here. Let's say that's how it looks like. So I'll write this down for you guys. For the direction, all I have to worry about is take the vector v divided by its magnitude so we can get the unit factor in that direction. And later on, we just have to multiply by the length and then we'll be done. But in this case though, the direction is actually opposite of v, right? So it will be the negative of that. So negative v divided by its magnitude. Now let's talk about the length. So notice I'm like writing it down in words because I don't want to put like the magnitude because it's quite tricky and I want to make it slightly more clear for you guys. Okay. Here, this and that, you can look at this as a right triangle. Adjacent, hypotenuse, and the angle between them. So we can use cosine. So you can just think about it as cosine theta equals whatever this thing is, right? The projection, the length for it divided by the magnitude of u. And then multiply this on both sides to get the length of the projection, right? So I'm just going to put this down right here for you guys. It's the magnitude of u times cosine of the angle between them. So that's okay. And here, the angle theta is acute. So cosine theta here is positive when angle is in between of 0 and 90 degrees because it's acute. Now, for this right here though, the formula will be the same. This is the magnitude of u times cosine of theta, except for one little thing. Here, this would be negative because we have obtuse case. So we're in like the second quadrant of the unit circle, yeah? And let me just indicate that theta is in between of 90 degrees and 180 degrees. If it happens to be 180 degrees, it's just U itself, but other direction. So yeah. But the length cannot be negative. It's okay. Because this right here is the formula, all we have to do is multiply by a negative again. So as you can see, we have the direction and the length. Direction and the length. We just had to multiply them, so I can tell you that right here, the projection of U onto V doesn't matter which case that we are looking at. It's just going to be, magnitude of U times cosine theta times the unit factor. Yeah, negative times negative happens to cancel, so that's quite nice. Now, let me just keep this picture, and I want to work out this a little bit more for you guys, so we can end up with a nicer formula. Here we go. First, this is from what we have earlier, and we see that we have cosine theta. And of course, we don't like this, because most likely, we will just be given U and V. So how can we take care of cosine theta? Well, the answer for that is the dot product. So, let me remind you guys, if we have U dot V, this right here is equal to the magnitude of U times the magnitude of V times cosine of the angle between them. Here I want to get cosine theta, so let's divide this on both sides. So cosine theta equals U dot V divided by the product of their magnitudes. So let me put this right here for cosine theta, and then we will end up the magnitude of U times U dot V divided by the magnitude of U times the magnitude of V, finally times V over its magnitude. And right here we see that the magnitude of U cancel, assuming that U is not the zeros factor. So this is what we have. Now, this is going to be a number. This is also going to be a number. This is the factor. So let's put all the numbers together. So this is U dot V on the top over this times that, which is just the magnitude of V squared. Yeah? And then we multiply by the factor V. So this is going to give us the projection. Well, in my opinion though, on the top we have the dot product already. So let's try to write the bottom as a dot product as well. And in fact, we can totally do so. Have a look. If today we are doing V dot itself, on the right hand side, I just have to do the magnitude of the first times the magnitude of the second, which is the same thing, right? Times the angle between them. But they are the same thing. The angle between them is zero. So cosine zero is one. So this is just the magnitude of V squared. So I'm going to use this backwards. And we can write this as U dot V over V dot V. And this is going to give us the number part, right? And then we just have to multiply by the factor V, and this is going to give us the projection, yeah, of U onto V. So now let me show you guys an example. First, this is our U and this is our V, and we will just have to do the dot product of them, which is 6 times 1 plus 3 times negative 2, and then plus 2 times negative 2. This right here is 6 minus 6 is 0, and then we have negative 4. Now, V dot V. So all we have to do is just look at 1 times itself, which is just the same as 1 squared, and then we add this square, which is negative 2 squared, and then negative 2 squared. So 1 plus 4 plus 4, we get 9. And finally, the projection of U onto V is equal to this divided by that. So we have negative 4 over 9. And remember, we are going to multiply by the factor V. Okay? So we have to multiply by I minus 2j and then minus 2k. just like this. And of course, we can multiply this out. We will end up negative 4 over 9 I positive 8 over 9 j, and finally positive 8 over 9 k. And that will do it.